Good morning, y'all. So, the markets are very interesting. I just discovered the whole Tether thing. I digged some deeper into that and Bitfinex. And I have to agree that it looks very bad. Very likely the funds of Tether have been stolen by probably some government agents, probably from the United States, and so that means that that's very similar to what happened to Mt. Gox. It's never been clear where the bitcoins went. Like, so many bitcoins got lost. They blame it on Mark Karpeles, the founder, but something is seriously off there. I think that someone stole a lot of bitcoins or even fiat stash from Mt. Gox, probably government agents, because who else could do that? But the way it unravels is so similar. At the time, with Mt. Gox had a lot of banking problems. Like, people couldn't withdraw money after a while, and so instead of withdrawing money, they would start buying Bitcoin to get out of the exchange, because you couldn't get out with US dollars or euros. So you had to buy Bitcoin to get out, and so it pumped the Bitcoin price. It was early 2014 when that started to unravel, and by that time Mt. Gox was not the biggest exchange anymore. Bitstamp had overtaken it by the end of 2013, during the bubble of 2013, the final one, $2,000. But after that, price started to crash, and then Mt. Gox problems started to appear, and the price of Bitcoin started to become very different on Mt. Gox than the price of Bitcoin on other exchanges. And from time to time, on these rebounds during bears, price was pumped there the hardest, and the high was the highest, and so it. But it, I remember that I found it very, like, unfounded. Yeah, price goes up because of people want to get out of Mt. Gox, but and Mt. Gox was not the leading exchange anymore, but still had a very high volume and a high standing. So it did lead the price somewhat of Bitcoin, and so. Very similar thing happening today with many exchanges that use Tether, USDT. Many people want to get out of Tether, but they can't get out by withdrawing, converting to US dollars, USDT to US dollars, and then withdrawing the fiat. People choose the other option, which is just buying Bitcoin and get out of there, out of Bitfinex and others. And because several exchanges are dependent on USDT, I didn't do in-depth research, but I was reading Bittrex also used it a lot, Poloniex also used it a lot, Kraken also has one of the biggest pairs on USDT versus US dollars, so many exchanges are exposed to risk there. And but interesting is that, for example, on Bitfinex, the prices of Bitcoin are about $160 higher on Tether exchanges, like Bitfinex, than on other exchanges, US dollars exchanges, fiat exchanges like Bitstamp and Kraken. Or Coinbase. Interesting is what happened in 2014 when Mt. Gox finally halted withdrawals. Then it was a few more months that people could get out via Bitcoin, but then suddenly that was finished too, and the exchange was shut down. And so everybody that still had Bitcoin there and fiat, so it disappeared for many years. And up until today, the same will likely happen here, because the thieves are U.S. government, and these guys well, they are the best robbers in the world. And so they will not let go of the fiat they confiscated. That's for them now. They will find many excuses why they take the money, but it doesn't really matter. The money is gone, and the money is, well, it's yours if you have USDT. So Bitfinex, I mean, an exchange cannot survive if it's getting robbed empty. So it will probably unravel at some point, and it means in practice that everybody that still has an account on Bitfinex with fiat on or crypto on will probably see it suddenly be gone. Like, it's not gone officially. You will get it maybe back later, sometime in the future, or maybe not. So, but what will be the impact on fiat, on Bitcoin values and crypto values? Well, we saw it happen in 2014. At first it pumped the price, and then it dumped the price really, really hard to new lows. So, likely this will happen again, considering there are so many other indicators that the bottom is not in, and that the bear market will take longer. This will just add fuel to the fire. Then, of course, the Mt. Gox story is also more coming to a close, and it looks like there will be Bitcoin and Bitcoin Cash distributed to coin holders, and that all seems to be coming together with an expected bottom around the middle of 2019, and then the Tether unraveling. I think odds are going up a lot, chances are going up a lot that we will see a new low, but it will become very, very difficult to buy that new low, because there will be lots of panic. Many people will have lost their money. Scandals, big scandals coming out, extreme insecurity shared among the whole community. Like, if half of the exchanges go broke, who dares to send fiat to an exchange to buy the dip, yet another dip, a dip again deeper than the other one, like these bear markets become worse and worse, there's no denying this. And it will be again the case, while the bull markets become weaker and weaker. Of course, that's all true. What's also true is that crypto has been a tremendous money maker, the best investment of the past decade by far. Enormous returns never seen before in the world of investing, even during the dot-com bubble in the 90s, internet bubble, yes. Some people made fortunes there too, but for a passive investor, crypto has offered a lot more returns, a lot more than internet companies, who would only go sell their shares after they are already worth many, many millions, often for an empty box. I mean, that's not the case with crypto. Like, you can get in at valuations of a few 10k or a few 100k, not 100 million plus, so you can get in much earlier and therefore make much higher returns, because the market caps in the end will be the same. It's not the same yet. The crypto, the internet bubble went a lot higher than the crypto bubble went, but that will change. So it's not crypto is okay, but it's going to be very, very hard to buy the low, and so you have to be very smart on how you manage your fiat stash. You have to be very selective where you keep that safe. A bank account has much lower counterparty risk than a crypto exchange, but you do have to have it at the crypto exchange in order to buy the low, so you need to balance these things. And of course, a crypto exchange, you have of many different varieties and qualities, so you cannot be having fiat or crypto in an exchange exposed to USDT. That's way too risky now. So you really need to have your things in order if you want if you want to buy the bottom that is likely to come. And also on a side note, Bitcoin Cash still doing very well. I mean, this is the new kid on the block. You can see that the way it's acting in price, it's much more volatile. It gets beaten down a lot more during crashes, but it also goes up the most during rebounds, and it's still at fifth marketplace ranking. But of course, if you get a bottom, actually chances, even though I always say the inverse, but actually chances are very high, it will also make a new low and the shit will come down the drain there, of course, too. People will be bitching, why insulting it, putting it down, and some scandals will of course probably hit it too. Who knows what can happen, huh? In any case, lots of Bitcoin Cash will be distributed by to Mt. Gox adapters and will likely be liquidated, since so few people believe in Bitcoin Cash in the broad crypto market, huh? So you will have to also not only buy the crypto dip or bottom, but in my opinion also buy the right coins. And I would say it's basically, in my opinion, it's Ethereum and Bitcoin Cash. From the top 10, I might miss one or two that I haven't studied, but so many projects have very weak foundations, even in the top 10. So there are only a few that are worth it for the first few years of the next bull market to be invested in. And that's, in my opinion, these two. So hope you enjoyed the video. I'm back on the beach. I think the big advantage here is that I've made a big mistake in the last bubble to expect higher prices, but bull markets just always disappoint in the sense that they really don't reach previous returns compared to previous bull markets. Look at the Trollo chart, overvaluation goes down a lot over time, but it's not true with bear markets, so that's the advantage of the bear here, that historical patterns are in his favor now. And even if we get a new bottom of 80 billion, that's still a lot higher than where we're coming from. We're going from 3 billion at the start of the last bull market. We went to 800 billion. If we bottom at 80 billion, that's only normal. You do times 200, you're gonna go down times 10. After that, to correct, you're still up times 20. So it's only logical. Check my previous video, very good, sideways move expected till 2022. I'll have to correct that a little. Actually, it's actually only till 2020 that I expect fiat price to be the same as today, so that's still 1 year, but in the meantime we probably go to 2500 for Bitcoin, but in 1 year we will still see 4000 Bitcoin, because when we get that new bottom, it will be a wipeout of the bulls, and it will take a long time before they are back. So markets won't move much the first year, but it is very, very important to buy the bottom, in my opinion, as I also explained in the previous video, at the end of the video. Ta-dee-da, wee-do-do-dee, tee-dee-da-da-dee-dee-da-da. Ta-dee-da, wee-do-do-dee, tee-dee-da-da-dee-dee-da-da. Ta-dee-da, wee-do-do-dee, tee-dee-da-da-dee-dee-da-da. Ta-dee-da, wee-do-do-dee, tee-dee-da-da-dee-dee-da-da. Da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-dee-da-d
Mm-hmm.